power that work within you. So today and today we're going to examine four lepers sitting at the gate. The title is going to be, if you sit there, you'll die. Next Sunday we're going to look at Esther, where she declares, if I perish, let me perish. If you stay silent, you'll die. Third Sunday we're going to look at the three Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. If you bow down, you'll die. And on the fourth Sunday, we're going to examine Abraham. Where God instructed him to give up everything he had and go. If you hold back, you'll die. Go big or go home. A phrase that context connotes that we need to go all the way. I said in our watching service, if we want to shift from just surviving to thriving, give God your best. Before I get into the sermon, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 26, God can do exceedingly and abundantly beyond all we can ask or think. But this is the part of the scripture you have to heed to. According to the power that works in us. In other words, God will only do what you give him room to do. And if you believe you serve a big God who can do big things, I dare you this year to have big faith. To go big. And so, let us turn in our Bibles to 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 7. 2 Kings chapter 7. I'm going to read verses 3 to 11. And then I'm going to skip down to verse 16. 2 Kings chapter 7. Beginning in verse 3. When you found it, just say, I got it. Amen. Now there were four leprous men outside the city gate who said to one another, why should we sit here until we die? If we say, let us enter the city, the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. But if we sit here, we shall also die. Therefore, let us desert to the Arabian camp. If they spare our lives, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall. But how? So they arose at twilight to go to the Arabian camp. But when they came to the edge of the Arabian camp, there was no one there at all. For the Lord had caused the Arabian army to hear the sound of chariots and of horses, the sound of a great army, so that they said to one another, the king of Israel has hired the king of the Hittites and the king of Egypt to fight against us. So they fled away in the twilight and abandoned their tents, their horses, and their donkeys, leaving the camp just as it was, and fled for their lives. When these leprous men had come to the edge of the camp, they went into a tent, ate and drank, carried off silver, gold, and clothing, and went and hid them. Then they came back, entered another tent, carried off things from it, and went and hid them. Then they said to one another, what we're doing is wrong. This is a day of good news. If we're silent and wait until the morning light, we'll be found guilty. Therefore, let us go and tell the king's household. So they came and called the gatekeepers of the city and told them, we went to the Arabian camp, but there was no one to be seen or heard, nothing but the horses tied, the donkeys tied, and the tents as they were. that the gatekeepers called out and proclaimed it to the king's household. And verse 16, then the people went out and plundered the camp of the Arameans. So a measure of choice meal was sold for a shekel, and two measures of barley for a shekel, according to the word of the Lord. I want to preach to you this morning using as a title, don't sit there and die. Don't sit there and die. Sometimes God puts you in a position and a place of, what do I have to lose? For some of us, 2013 was a banner year. You felt blessed beyond measure. You experienced the move of God in your life like never before. And you're entering the new year with eyes wide open, with anticipation and expectation for God to do it again. But for some of us, 2013 was filled with setbacks and roadblocks. Instead of anticipation and expectation, your heart is full of agitation and frustration. Some of us have a nagging anxiety or fear that something bad will happen this year like it did last year. You've been disappointed one too many times. You've struggled for one too many days. You've stayed up for one too many nights. You made it to the new year, but just barely made it. You literally dragged yourself into the new year. Regardless of your particular type of transition into the new year, the reality of it is no one can afford in a new year with new opportunities, with new potential, to become complacent and satisfied where you're at. Success has to be injected into your DNA. You have to begin or continue to train yourself to go beyond where you're at, to extend your faith, to extend your trust, to broaden your horizon and believe this year will be your best year, not by accident, but by intention. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Success is not accidental. Success is intentional. You gotta have focus, resolve, ambition, a plan, goals, and determination if you're gonna give success a fighting chance. In order to succeed, you first can't be afraid to fail. The fear of failure can be a formidable opponent if you give it room. You can't be afraid to apply or reapply. You can't be afraid to dust yourself off, pick yourself up, and try again. So what if it didn't happen this way? You have to believe God can still do it that way. So what if it didn't happen today?
To perform on your behalf.
there until we die. If we say, let us enter the city, the family's in the city, and we'll die there. But if we sit here, we'll also die. So they decided, let's go to the Arameans. If they spare us, we'll live. But if they kill us, we're going to die anyway. And before we examine anything else, these four individuals had three strikes against them. One, they were lepers. Two, they were socially rejected. That's what happened as a result of leprosy. Hence their position outside the city. And thirdly, there was a famine in the land. And so these four men find themselves at a point of desperation. I find it interesting how God will sometimes put you in a place of desolation and desperation to propel you to act. Because some of us wouldn't come to church if we didn't have any trouble. Some of us wouldn't pray if the devil wasn't attacking. But this year, I dare you to learn to praise God, not just when you need him, but allow 2014 to be your year of praise, regardless of what's transpiring around you, to not just pray when you need him, but to pray because you love him. Oh, can I get some help this morning? And so these men, seeing the situation, saw the need to act. They said, if we stay here, we'll die. If we go in the city, we'll die. Let's put our life in the hands of the Arameans. They realized the seriousness of their situation. Worse than being in a bad situation is not realizing you're in a bad situation. You ever seen someone in a relationship and everybody and their mom knows this, but they they're walking around talking about licking my boo, and your boo is tore up on the floor. Emotionally, they're a mess. Spiritually, they're a mess. Not doing right, not treating you right. And you're thinking this is how it's supposed to be. That's all right. Maybe the reason why you don't see their mess is because you're a hot mess. I'm trying to help somebody. Denial is almost as deadly as death. Because when you're in denial, you're dying and don't even know it. But these four individuals saw the seriousness of their situation and said, we have to do something. Because something is better than nothing. You can't be about nothing and serve a God who's always up to something. He's always moving. He's always preparing. God is always up to something. Even right now, he's preparing your next blessing. Even right now, he's moving and shifting behind the scenes. But you'll miss it if you just sit there. God will do the miracle, but you have to walk in it. God will move people out of your way and bring people you need in your way. But you need to believe the risk is worth the reward. That where I'm going is what is worth what I'm leaving. The problem with some of us is we're trying to bring stuff from last year into this year. And God is saying, you need to leave the junk to get the truth.
things to him for your part. And I'm talking to somebody, and sometimes it feels like your life is falling apart. But you've got to believe that the best is still yet to come. He still has the best for me. He still has the best for my family. He still has the best for my finances. He still has the best for my job. I look at your neighbor and tell them you ain't seen nothing yet. But he still has the best, the best, the best, the best.
They said, we have to do something because something is better than nothing. They took a risk. Matter of fact, risked their very lives. One, because they were lepers. Two, because they were Israelites. And the Israelites were the enemies of the Arameans. Very often, success comes with a risk. You have to be willing to risk it in order to win it. So these four men went down into the enemy's camp, not knowing what awaited them, only knowing what's ahead of me has to be better than what's behind me. And watch what verse 5 says. So they arose at twilight to go to the Arameans.
God, if you give him room to be. there may be another. There may be another. You're ready, you're ready, you're ready. You're ready to let go and give it to God. You're ready to let go and give it to God. You're ready to turn it over to God. Challenging someone.